Jimmy Savile, once one of the BBC's brightest stars, revealed after his death as a serial sexual predator who raped and abused over decades. His monstrous legacy casting a long shadow over the corporation.
Savile was a danger to young people, both girls and boys, opportunistic and shameless. I have identified 72 BBC victims of Savile, of whom 34 were under the age of 16. His youngest victim was aged 8. His abuse included 8 cases of rape, the youngest victim being only 10 years old.
It wasn't just Savile. Fellow presenter Stuart Hall was convicted and jailed in 2014 for the indecent assault of young girls. How both men could have hidden in plain sight, and who at the BBC knew what, the subject of a 3-year independent inquiry, with serious failings found in what the review chair Dame Janet Smith termed a deferential and macho management culture, where star talent was treated with kid gloves.
There was a culture of not complaining or of raising concerns. BBC staff felt and were sometimes told that it was not in their best interests to pursue a complaint. Loyalty to and pride in a programme could hinder the sharing of concerns. There was a reluctance to rock the boat.
But this report does. Some of the details are shocking. One victim was told, "Keep your mouth shut, he's a VIP." That even with plenty of material out in the public eye which cast doubt over Jimmy Savile's character, BBC bosses didn't think to remove him from his position of unfettered access to vulnerable young people. The main finding, though, that senior management did not know, that the BBC as a corporation was not aware. Liz Dux, who represents 168 of Savile's victims, says she doesn't believe it.
You get the feeling from reading that report that you just had to scratch the surface and Savile was there to be uncovered. And that shows a fairly high degree of knowledge to me.
BBC Director General Tony Hall offered a heartfelt apology to the victims.
It was a dark chapter in the history of the organisation, but a much darker one for all of you. The BBC failed you when it should have protected you. I am deeply sorry for the hurt caused to each and every one of you.
Two men lauded when they should have been jailed. The BBC now trying to put this shameful episode behind it. Diana Magnay, CNN, London.